right now, we're good to go. Good to see everybody this morning. Got a great crowd here for staff meeting this first Sunday of the year. I know a lot of times we talk about law of first mention. So since there's this many people here for staff meeting the first Sunday of the year, that means this will be the minimum number for the rest of the year, right?
Sure.
Yeah, we'll always have this bigger crowd or bigger every time for the rest of the year. So that's an awesome thing. Let's talk about atmosphere just for a second. I want to remind you that anything removed from its atmosphere of life will not live. You cannot hold a bird underwater. If you hold a bird underwater, it's outside of its atmosphere of life and it will not survive. Will for just a little while, but it won't be able to prosper underwater. You take a fish, you pull it out of the water, throw it up on the bank, that fish may live for a little while. It might live even, you know, if it's a good old catfish, it might live for a day. But it won't live forever because anything taken out of its environment of life will not survive. And I want to ask you this morning, what's your environment of life? Think about it. If you take something out of its environment of life and it will always die, even if it takes a day or two, what does your environment of life look like? What is your atmosphere of life? What do you need in your life around you, surrounding you, to keep you alive, to keep you prospering, to keep you being able to do the things that God called you into? And when we start thinking about atmosphere, whatever the atmosphere of your personal life is, let me tell you that as staff, when we come together in one mind and one accord, the atmosphere of your personal life combines with the atmosphere of my personal life, and it creates one large personality and one large atmosphere for the church. So identify that. Ask yourself, as heroes of faith and soldiers well armed, what do I need to have as an atmosphere around my life? What does my prayer life need to look like? What does my Bible reading need to look like? What does my personal worship need to look like? Because that way when we come together in one mind and one accord as the staff of this church, we bring our own personal atmosphere of life together and we combine them. Y'all all know the scripture says that a threefold cord is not easily broken.
Yes.
If I take three strings, I wind them together. You might break one of them individually, but you won't break the three of them winded together, weaved together. And think about that as an atmosphere of life. The enemy might come in and he might disrupt one of our atmospheres of life for a day or two. But if we come in together and we've all been prospering in our atmosphere of life and we pull it together and come in one mind and one accord and we become a multifold cord of atmosphere of life weaved together, what could happen in this place? What could happen if we come together in one mind and one accord? So just keep that in mind this morning. My heroes of faith, be prepared and ready to be that atmosphere of life for those who are going to come in. The world's full of the atmosphere of death.
Right.
The world's full of the atmosphere of darkness. And when the people show up this morning, especially the visitors that come in, and even possibly people that have been here a long time, unfortunately, that atmosphere of darkness out there leaves a stain on us sometimes. We're out there, and it's like working in a dusty environment. It gets on your clothes, it gets on your skin, it gets in your hair. It affects you when you're out there in it. And when they come in, they're going to be looking for an atmosphere of life that'll blow all the dust of that darkness off of them where they can be rejuvenated. So let's just be sure we have an atmosphere of life this morning for all those people coming in. When I'm kind of rushing through that because I really wanted to tell you this morning. 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 6. Wonderful story that we've often heard about. How many of you know about the cruise of oil unfailing? I believe there's even an old hymnal song. If you pull out that little blue book out from under the seats, you'll find a song called the cruise of oil unfailing. I don't think that's the exact name of it, but that's the song is about this particular story that we have here. 2 Kings chapter 4 verse 6 says this. Now it came to pass when the vessels were full that she said to her son, bring me another vessel. And he said to her, there's not another vessel, so the oil ceased. Goes right, interesting that it goes right along with this atmosphere, what the Lord gave me this morning before I even got here to show that. When I was praying this morning, I asked, Lord, what do you want me to say to my staff this morning? What do you want me to tell them? And instantly, I didn't even hardly get it out of my mouth praying it this morning. Instantly, I heard him say, tell them get ready for the rain. Now, I know, guys, that the weatherman said it may have a little rain today, and that's not what he was talking about. He wasn't telling me to send you out to get an umbrella to hold over your head to keep the physical rain off of you. Right. What he was telling me is to tell you to get prepared for the rain.
Yes.
Ahab was the king had been chasing Elijah. And Elijah was up on the mountain, and there'd been a drought for 3 years. And he'd said the rain's going to come. And they were up on the mountain, and they were praying for the drought to break. And he kept sending his servant over to look out over the sea. And the servant would come back and say, "I see nothing. Go and look again." Come back, "I see nothing." Go and look again. Come back, "I see nothing." And he sent him one time, and he came back, and he said, "Well, you know what? I see a cloud rising up out of the ocean the size of a man's hand." And he said, "Get you down. The rain is coming." Right. And he ran down to King Ahab, and he said, "You better get yourself back to the castle, because the rain is coming." And he hitched up his blue jeans, and he took off. The Bible says he ran ahead of the chariot all the way back to the gates of the city. And I believe that's what God is telling us, each and every one. We need to get ourselves ready for the rain. There is a rain coming that's going to fall down on this church. We have seen great and mighty things. But there is a rain coming that's going to fall down on this church. The problem is, if we are not prepared and ready to receive that rain as a vessel, then the rain will stop.
Amen.
Notice what I read here. She said to the kids, "Go and give me another bucket. Quick, go get me another bucket." She was pouring oil. And the day the buckets got satisfied, the rain stopped.
My goodness.
Think about what I just said. The day that every vessel in her house got satisfied, the rain stopped. And so as I was talking about atmosphere this morning, I want to tell you one of the things about the atmosphere of life for this church and for all of us. We need to be spiritually dissatisfied. I'm not talking about dissatisfied with our King. I'm not talking about dissatisfied with the move of the Holy Ghost. But I'm talking about being hungry all the time. Right. Never getting satisfied. Never getting, you know, we can come to the place that we come in and say, "Oh my goodness, no preaching again today. The Spirit just moved." We can come to the place where we can say, "How are they going to ever quit praying? We've been praying 45 minutes already." We can come to the place that we come into the house, and when the rain of the Holy Ghost is falling upon us, that we say, "My vessel is full, and I've had enough of that. I don't need any more rain. My cup is full to the overflow." And the day that we come in with that attitude, the rain will stop falling, because the cruise of oil will have filled us to the place that we're satisfied. Well, I want to ask you this morning, staff, do this for me if you would please. If your vessel is almost full, run over there real quick, grab a hold of it, dump about half of that out, pour it out on the ground, let the ground soak it up. Let's get our heart prepared and ready for the rain. I know that God's got a rain for us in 2018. He's got a rain prepared. I see the cloud coming up out of the ocean like the hand of a man. And I say, let us get the vessel empty. Let us prepare ourselves and say, "God, whatever the rain is that you've got for us, I want it. I'm ready for it. I'm hungry for it. I refuse to be satisfied with what we've already had. There's hunger within me for a moving power of your Spirit." So let's get ready for the rain this morning. Let's circle up and pray about it. Father, I pray.